Hello friends, today I gave a guest lecture at Christ University MBA batch to the finance students, and the topic of the guest lecture was very relevant to the market. The topic was workshop on technical analysis using TradingView, and we tried to cover basics of technical analysis, some of the basic trading strategies, and also blend it a little bit with fundamental analysis, and then take TradingView as a tool. Give basic idea of how TradingView works and how the whole technical analysis could be done using the TradingView. So that was the whole workshop, and happily the management, the Christ management, happily agreed to share this video with overall public audience. So please feel free to watch the video and learn, and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel. And if you have any comments on, on the content, or you want me to cover certain topics in detail, do post your comments on the YouTube link, and we will be happy to, put some of those videos. Thanks and enjoy the video. Thank you. So what we are going to do today is, because the session is on technical analysis, and we discussed that we should try to make it more hands-on. I tried to pick up one tool by using which we do technical analysis to do day-to-day work. So what I'll be covering is bit of technical analysis basics, and then get into some of the technical analysis strategies. And I understand you guys are from finance background, so I have tried to have the flavor of finance also, because all these things, they talk to each other, and only when lot of these things come together, the incremental value is extracted. So we'll try to see a little bit of finance and how we can blend finance and technical analysis using the tool TradingView, and then how we can take buy or sell decisions in the market, and that is how the investments or tradings are made, and profit is made. So this is what we are going to do now. In terms of the agenda, we will be spending half an hour approx on the technical analysis basics. And I believe you would have already gone through, the very basic, like the price, the volume, some indicators like moving averages, some concepts like support and resistance, trends. So I will try to, quickly walk through you through each of these in 30 minutes, assuming you have a fair knowledge of these topics. And then we will jump into this tool called TradingView, where first we will try to, get a technical view of how to use this tool. And all the concepts which we have learned in technical analysis, like support, resistance, moving average, plotting charts, how we do it in TradingView. And once we do this, so which means we know the basics of technical analysis, we know the basics of the TradingView tool, then we will try to learn a little bit of trading strategies. Like there are different ways of making money, like, even as an investor or as an entrepreneur, somebody, creates business in education sector, somebody does in entertainment sector. So same way, even in trading, there are different strategies, and one needs to find what works for him based on his own behavior, his own expectations, his own timelines. So we'll try to cover one or two simple strategies in 15 minutes, and then we will use the TradingView tool, and we will try to go through some live examples of, last 1 year, or in fact, maybe in the current market, how we can apply some of these strategies and how we can see and analyze these opportunities for trading using the TradingView tool. And we will discuss 5 use cases, and then we will have some time for, Q&A and general discussion, where, we can have generic discussion even beyond this topic, whether you want to cover more in terms of technical analysis, or you want to have queries related to, whatever we went through, and, we will go through all of that. So I will suggest you hold your queries till the end of session, or till the end of each and every section. That is when, we'll take a stop, and, we'll take some of the questions if you are not clear about some of the concepts, and we'll progress. So that's the agenda. I think already my introduction has been made, but just to, give some examples, and why I want to highlight, because I know you guys are from finance world. This is your time to learn. And these are some of the really exciting portals where you'll find a lot of interesting work, which is being done by, people like, you and me. And there are a lot of investors who present their ideas, how to invest. And there is a lot of learning which happens from the Western world. So what I would suggest is try to go through some of these portals. I will share this deck with you. you will find a lot of insights on how to do financial analysis, what are the different, you know, types of investing strategies, what are the different types of trading strategies are done. So I just try to highlight some of them, and some of these forums I have been lucky enough to present, and these are some of the links for my presentation. One, this is not a presentation, but I was glad, and for me it was a really big moment when Parag Parikh Mutual Fund, it is one of the most well-known fund, and the fund manager Mr. Rajiv Thakkar, he also mentioned my name in, you know, some of the you know, learnings he had on the quants investment. So I cherish. And this is my Twitter profile. I do post frequently about markets, about fundamental analysis, about quants, about technical analysis. And this is the YouTube channel. And as ma'am mentioned, I run a program called Scientific Investing, where we cover technical analysis, fundamental analysis. So these are, you know, some of the courses which are there. This is my blog where I post about companies, about analysis and all of this. So this is a little bit of brief introduction. So we'll try to, you know, keep it interactive. So the good part is we have a tool, and I hope all of you have access to TradingView tool. I sent a mail. So those who don't have access, just log into this tool before we start so that, you know, you are ready. And you can go to this https://in.tradingview. I'll just post it here in the chat, and you can, you know, just see it, and, you know, you can access it. Okay, where is it gone? Oh, it's here. Okay. Yeah. So let me just put it in the chat. So just go to this tool, and you know, we don't need to download any software, nothing. It's all in the cloud through a URL. All you need to do is just create a user ID for yourself. And in case it asks for pricing, just pick the free version, because, you know, all of this we can do it freely. So just be ready with that. And we will keep it interactive. So I have few questions for you, and just reply, and accordingly we will proceed. So how many of you have ever invested in the markets? Can you, you know, just type a yes in case you have. If you have not invested, given I understand many of your students may not have work ex, may not have invested, but has anybody invested in market? You can just type yes. Okay, so there are few who have invested. That's good. So at least there are 4 or 5 people who have invested. Okay. My next question is, so those who have invested in the markets, how do you do the background research? Do you read annual reports? Do you read conference call transcripts to make your investment decisions? How do you do it? Do you read annual reports and con call transcripts? Okay. Okay. I see. Okay, so there are few who read annual reports. There are few who go through the news and they invest. Good. So there is, you know, at least there is, you know, some activeness around, you know, how to make. I'm sure when you are having your, you know, financial courses, you will go through a lot of annual reports, a lot of financial statements. You will do all the financial analysis, ratio analysis. And I know it's a technical analysis lecture, but still I'm asking these questions because we will see how to, you know, connect these dots, because a lot of these things are interrelated. So my next question is, how many of you have seen this series called Scam 1992? It came, I think, 3-4 months back on, you know, Sony Pix, and it became one of the most popular series. How many of you have seen this Scam 1992 series? Can you type yes? Yes, 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 yes. Okay, so looks like a lot of people have seen Scam, so at least it is relevant. So, you know, you will know through Scam, you know, what all happens in the market. So if not through the books and charts, at least, you know, through this series. And I think it was a beautiful series. And actually, the research help which has been taken on, you know, this content, the couple which you see there, Sucheta Dalal and her husband, they run a forum called Money Life. And Money Life has been working, you know, towards investors' benefit. So the research done is quite good because of the people who were behind it. So I hope some of the learning, so some of the learnings which you had while watching Scam could be useful, because the market discussions you'll be able to connect. Now, next question, how many of you trade in stock market? And when I say trade means not a long-term investment, more like you buy and sell using technical analysis, using charts. So how many of you trade in the market? So I see one, Rimjim, I see Rajat, Rohit. So good, there are a few traders, and looks like there are a bit more investors than traders, Ayush. So good. How many of you have seen this movie called The Big Short? Okay. So you will know what Big Short is all about. I hope many of you would have read about the 2008 recession and how it happened. In fact, to give a background, I was doing my MBA at that time, like you. And I will tell you the story. We were in the first year, our summer internship, presentations were just starting. Lehman Brothers presented like they presented yesterday, and everybody wanted to, join and do internship in Lehman Brothers. And the next day, what we hear is Lehman Brothers collapsed. And just imagine, like, that was like horrible time. And then we saw our seniors struggling for placements and all. So Big Short is a movie which is based on, the whole 2007 bubble, how it happened. And, there are a few set of guys who could decode it, and, they could do the reverse trade, which is shorting, and they made big money. So I believe some of you are aware of the market through investment, some of you are aware through trading, some of you read the annual report, some of you have watched the series Scam, some of you have seen the Big Short movie. So not only the education, but your normal financial lectures, your hands-on experience, and even your entertainment experience. Let's bring all of this together. And let's see, how all of this experience helps us in, next few minutes or hours. So there is something interesting which happened in last 1 year, and we all have gone through the COVID, and these are times when these guest lectures we are doing through online platforms and digital platforms. And when COVID happened, everybody went in shock. The market also went in a shock. But look what has happened in last 1 year, and this data I have prepared taking yesterday. So this today is nothing but yesterday, but given it's a Saturday in terms of market days, it's valid. Between today and last 365 days, and what I have done is I have taken out the companies which have today less than 100 crore of market cap. So we are left with 1,261 companies. Out of these 2,261 companies, there are 1,173 companies which have given more than 100% return despite all COVID precipices. And there are 66 companies which have given more than 500% return in last 1 year. And you know what is the FD rate of return? Like it's 5%, 6%, 7%. And I know it is an academic session, but still, I'm talking in all this language because the best feel of, all this learning happens when you are there in the market. So I mean, what I would suggest is, when we are in learning phase, we don't need to play big because first we need to ensure, we don't get into losses, and, having a proper learning is important. But when I started my journey during my MBA days, this is how it started. I just created a small 5,000 or 10,000 rupee portfolio, which I call, it is like my tuition fee to the market. Like we pay for an MBA degree, we pay for courses. That is how I thought this is my tuition fee to the market, and I try to have all the learning. And as a student, 10,000 also is a decent amount, because when you play with real money, you get the feel of what you are doing, whether it is working, it is not, because there is some stake at the place. So I'm taking these real examples because these real examples acts as somewhere motivation to learn why it happened, because everything can't happen because of luck. If these 66 companies made 5 times more return than these remaining 570 companies, why they were different? What different happened here? And could we, was it possible to identify it using technical analysis and some of which we are going to discuss? Was it possible to identify these companies using the financial analysis, using the fundamental analysis, course which you are doing? And we'll try to see that some of this was possible and we could have done it. So that is the whole intent, and to get the motivation running because we are talking about serious money and serious business of making money. And the whole idea of, you know, job is one part, but even in your job, some of you will, you know, work as equity advisor. Some of you can end up being a fund manager, or you can manage funds for your organization, maybe in treasury department and whatnot. But the idea will be, you know, to, you know, make real money. And that is where, you know, all of this comes through. So what has happened in last 1 year, it is very motivating to see. And the markets, they work so opposite to normal perception that when there is so much of gloom and doom, that is where, you know, this kind of money could be made. And that is where, you know, we should try to separate emotions, and we should try to be more more academic, more data driven, more learning driven, and less of our gut feel and, you know, the whole fear and greed mentality. And that is where all this learning which we are having in our MBA degree, or we are going to have through some of these, you know, guest learning sessions, let's try to leverage and see how it makes sense. So first I will start with the technical analysis basics. And I have been told that, you know, some of these basic concepts you have covered, so I might be a little faster. Please use the chat window. Stop me if you feel I am being faster, because I think you would have gone through, and hence I am trying to be little faster. But stop me if you feel I am fast, or stop me. Just ping me on the chat if you feel, you know, you don't know these concepts. So what is technical analysis all about? So, you know, there are different ways of making money. And some people, they make money by understanding the financials of the company, by doing the P&L balance sheet analysis. Some people, they invest by, you know, getting a sense of management. They try to, you know, ride the jockey. They have a sense of identifying who is a good management, who can, you know, do wonders. And some people, they make money by trading, where they use not the financial data, but the trade data, which is the daily price data, like the stock market, the stock wise open price, close price, how much volume has flown. And we call it flow, float, and flavor. Flow is like in which stock more money is flowing. And there is a reason why money is flowing. Like, it's very simple demand supply analysis. Like, let us say if you are going out in the market to buy vegetables, you know, some days, in some months, you'll see onion is selling at 30 rupee per kg. I don't go out to, even though I go out to buy, I don't remember exactly, but this is just for example. Sometimes you'll see onion is 30 rupee per kg, and the same onion is sometimes 90 rupee per kg. Why so much of difference? And the simple answer is demand supply. If there are too many people who are willing to buy a thing, and the supply shortage is there, then the price will go up. If there are too many people selling something and there are not much of buyers, then the, you know, then the supply crunch, supply is, oh, there is an oversupply situation, and hence the prices will fall. So just that example is what works in market also on a given day. On a given day, when a share is being traded, if there are more buyers than sellers, and if the buyers are more optimistic than sellers, if they are willing to pay any price to buy, the prices go up. And if it is the reverse, prices go down. And trading is all about understanding the demand supply game, whether we do it by seeing charts visually, or we do it by building algorithms, using this whole price and volume data and creating, you know, different metrics out of it. All of that is, in my view, is technical analysis. And flow is the flow of that money and the demand supply. Float is how much of that money as a total percentage in supply. Like, you will be knowing every company has some shareholders and it has shares. So let us say if Infosys has 100 shares, and let us say, this is again example, let us say 60% shares of Infosys is held by promoters. Now promoters don't buy and sell every day. Maybe once in a year, maybe they will offload a little bit. So you can assume promoters won't sell. So out of 160 shares is controlled by promoter, which is not being traded in the market. Let us say some long-term investors like big mutual funds, they have also 30% share, and they also don't sell on a regular basis. So out of 190 shares is not going to be traded on a daily basis. Ultimately, it is 10 shares. And from that 90, if you assume maybe 1 or 2%, so 12% could be the daily float for this stock. Versus another stock where only promoter is holding only 20%, and there is no mutual fund, and there are no long-term investors. So you might have out of 100 any day 80 shares being, you know, traded. So this whole concept of float is when there is very less shares being traded, there is a scarcity premium. And flavor is like, yeah, sometimes you will hear, oh my God, the world is going to change and EV electric vehicles are going to dominate. Or sometimes I know many of you will hear about the dot-com bubble, what happened in 2000. Like, you put the name dot-com even behind a metal company and the prices will shoot up, because market will assume you are going to open a website. I mean, One example I can give you, the price at which Microsoft traded in 2000, it took Microsoft 16 years to reach to the same price. That was the kind of overvaluation dot-com bubble brought. And it's not like Microsoft underperformed financially. Microsoft still kept doing well. Infosys, it took 8 years to, you know, reach the same 2000 price, despite Infosis growing at 20 to 30% between 2000 to 2008. So flavor is the third factor in trading. You ride the flavor of the market and trend. And this is what technical analysis is, to read the data, to read the chart based on the price action, based on the volume action, and then, you know, take a buy and sell call. So I hope all of you understand the basic of technical analysis. And when I see the price data, usually this is how the data will look like. I have taken one company called Advanced Enzyme Technologies, and this is like a daily level, and these are the dates. So this is the daily level data. You can have this data even at a hourly level. You can have this data at a monthly level. You can have this data at a weekly level. The idea is, whatever periodicity you are taking, for every periodicity, you will have an open price, the starting time of that periodicity at which the stock opened, the close price, the end time. So for this date, the market opens at 9:15 a.m. So this was the price when the stock opened at 9:15 a.m. This was the price at which stock closed at 3:30 p.m. And in that 6-7 hours, this was the highest price which the stock made, and this is the lowest price the stock made. And what is the total number of shares which got traded? And the total number of shares multiplied by the price at which they got traded, that is called the turnover, and total number of trades. So like in one trade, I might purchase 100 shares, and in one trade, I might purchase 1,000 shares. So what is the total count of trades which happened? And delivery volume is like, in the market, you can trade intraday and interday. Like, you can buy today and you can sell today itself, or you can buy today and you can retain it. So long-term investors, they like to retain it. So that is what is called delivery volume. So out of all these shares traded, what percentage of share was for delivery, which is 43%. So this is what a trade data is. And this is all the technical analysis, all the charting, all the ratio, all the algorithms, they run around this data. So I hope you have a fair sense of this data. So if you understood this data and you have broader idea of what a technical analysis is, you can type bull. If you are not understanding, type bear, and then we'll come what questions you have. Good, bull wins. We are good. So looks like we all are good. I don't see any bear, so good. So let's go ahead. Second is charts, because we are dealing about technical analysis, we have to deal with charts. So the basic thing to understand is, what is a chart and what are these, you know, green and red things we are seeing. Does anybody know what type of chart is this? You can type it if somebody knows what kind of chart is this. Okay, right. So good. A lot of people know all these things. So this is the candlestick chart, and there are different kinds of charting system. And we don't need to follow each of them because we all need to build our expertise. And candlestick charting system came from Japan. So I follow candlestick chart system. And there are a few things I want to highlight it. If you see, you have candlesticks, which is, this is a daily level chart. And why it is a daily level chart? Because if you see, this is a one day. So this is a daily level chart. Okay. And every candlestick is one day price data, which means the open price, the close price, high price, low price. So if you see this single candlestick, if the stock closed at a higher price than the open price, then you will see a green, and you can change the color. We will show in trading view tool, and this is the trading view tool. You can change the color, but the general notion is, if you are making money, you are in green. If you are making losses, you are in red. So if your share closed at a higher price than the open, it's green. If it closed at a lower price, it's a red. So if it is a green one, which means this is the open price, and this is the body, and, you know, and this is the wick. So the thin line is called the wick, and this part is called body. So between the open price to the close price, you have the body, and the starting point of the body on a day when it closes up, the starting point is the open price, and the end point here of the body is close price. And during the day, the stock would have made a higher value or a lower value. So this up is the high value, and this low is the low value. If you reverse it in terms of days when the stock was in red, which means the stock closed at a lower price than the open price. And if I mark this in terms of a red candle, then this becomes my open price. This becomes my close price. I just reverse of this. And this is again my high price and this is my low price. And this part is called shadow or wick and this part is called real body. And if you see this chart, maybe it's a 8 month of chart at a daily level. And you will see you have every day you have a candlestick and every day you will have a body, you will have a wick and you will have highs and lows and all. So this is how a basic chart price behaves. And this is how we capture the trade data of open, close, high, low in a candlestick chart. So let's jump to the next one. So I hope you have understood the whole concept of how to read a candlestick chart. Type again bull if you have understood how to read a candlestick chart. Good. We will jump to the next section. So next is the concept of trend. What is a trend? So trend is nothing but if you, this is same as the general word, the English word trend. Trend means something is trending. You hear on Twitter some keyword is trending. It means lot of people are following it, or this particular fashion style or this particular hairstyle is in trend, which means lot of people. Hello. I hope everything is fine.
Request the students to mute themselves.
Anaka, please mute. Anaka, yes.
So when we say this hairstyle is in trend, which means many people are following it. So stocks also have their own definition of trend. And in stock market, there are three kinds of trend. There is something called uptrend, there is something called downtrend, and there is something called range bound. Now, an uptrend is something where, the prices keep going up. And the way it is defined is, let us say this is a daily level price. So, stocks, they don't keep going up or they don't keep going down. They will go up a little bit, then few days they will correct, then again they will go up, they will correct. So it is said in this time frame, when there are higher highs and higher lows. So if you see the highs which have been made here is this is a high made here, then again this is a high made here, and this is a low made here. So till the next high is higher than the previous high, and the next low is higher than the previous low, and this trend continues, we can say the stock is in uptrend. And this is valid for all the asset classes where we talk of, whether we talk of stock or we talk of the Nifty, Sensex, index, cryptocurrency, commodities, the concepts are same. The whole technical analysis beauty is the concepts are same and you can apply the same concept across, each of them, where in fundamental, every company is different, every balance sheet is different, every, P&L statement is different. And a downtrend is when the prices are going down and the higher highs are lower than previous high and the lows are lower than the previous low. So if you see here in uptrend, this high was higher than previous high, this low was higher than previous low. In a downtrend, the stock even tries to go up, but it can never cross the previous high. So this high is lower than this previous high, and this low is lower than the previous low. So this is how an uptrend behaves. This is how a downtrend behaves. And in a range bound market, nothing happens. You just keep, it's like a pendulum from here to here. There is no higher highs, there are no higher lows. It just keeps shifting. And for a trader, this is the deadliest market because, if you ride an uptrend, you can go long. If you ride a downtrend, you can short. And shorting is the other way of making money. But here, all you can do is just playing between this if you are too good at trading, but you don't make big money. So this is what a basic trend analysis is. So why trends are important? So again, those of you who saw, scam, the dialogue comes again and again, risk hai to ishq hai. And still you have a character called Raju and he's not as known as charting Raju because Raju is good at charting. And you would have known by this time, there were some different personalities. Now the image is, and the general image also, like in my family, I think my father never went beyond FD. So the moment you say you are going to invest in market or you're going to trade in market, the general perception is that it's gamble, and you know, that's how the perception is in India. And even in scam, they say risk has to risk. In fact, if you go through the lectures or you interviews of all the big investors of India, like Mr. Ramdev Agrawal and everybody, most of them never used, I mean, they never went through deep annual reports. They will say, what we used to do is we just to look at PE ratio. That was the best analysis by the best investors that time. And chart and all, nobody would have even heard. But these things, because the Western markets are much more matured, like Western market, Indian market, we have a history of 30, 40 years. Western markets, they have a history of 100 plus years. And the kind of books, the kind of metric which you are reading, those things were defined, you know, 50, 60, 70 years back. So there was a, you know, system existing. And the idea is to why trend is important, because it's not like risk hai to risk hai. Trending and all these concepts, they help us to identify the risk and also identify the reward, and then play with the risk reward, so that if you lose money, you lose lesser, but if you make money, you make more of money. So your probabilities to success are in the favor, and that is what, you know, the whole learning is. So why trend is important? Because trend is your friend. And you need to ride the trend, and you need to be with the stock till the trend is there. And the moment the trend is out, you need to get out of, you know, the stock if you are long. So whether you are long or you are short depends on in which trend the stock or the market is, and you need to follow the trend. Now, this is one example of trend. This company is Abbott India. Abbott is a pharma company. It is more an OTC company. In many of our families, we have people, you know, suffering from diabetes, and you'll see this medicine called Thyronorm. Many people, you know, they eat on a regular basis. Abbott has that brand called Thyronorm. And if you see, this is the chart of Abbott. And I don't know how many of you, you know, track the market. 2018, 2019 were not such a good year for market. But even in that market, Abbott gave a very good return. And Abbott prices went from 7,000, 8,000 rupees to almost 14,000. And then in 2020, it did correct during COVID, but finally it went up to 19,000. So even when the broad market in 18 and 19, Nifty was still performing, but the mid cap and small cap didn't perform. Abbott was in uptrend. And how we can see the uptrend? So, you know, higher highs and higher lows. So see, if you start with this high and this low, this next high is higher than this. This next low is higher than this. Again, this high is higher than this. This low is higher than this. So, you know, till here, Abbott was in an uptrend. So this is how we define an uptrend. This is one example of uptrend. This is an example of a downtrend. There's a company called Mayur Unicoaters. So like those of you who drive a Maruti or something, so the seats which you see in the Maruti, the leather sheets. So one is a natural leather which comes out of, you know, animals, you know, bodies. But there is something called, you know, I request some of you to go in mute. Yeah, hello. Hello, I hope everything is good. Okay, so there is an artificial leather also, and this company Mayur makes those artificial leathers. They are called PU leathers. So this stock was in a downtrend in 2019. And as I said, most of the mid and small cap companies, they had a bad time in 2018 and 19. And you can see this downtrend because, you know, this price high was met, then it goes and it makes a low. It tries to go up and break that previous high, but it can't go. And this high is lower than this high. This low is higher. This low is lower than this low. Again, this high is lower than this high. Here, it didn't follow it perfectly in terms of low, but then finally he tried. It tried and it fell. So if you see, it's lower highs, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows. So this is a downtrend. And the range bound is something like this, where, you know, it's not going below this low, but it's not going beyond this high also. And it need not to be 100% accurate. It could be like 1-2% here and there. So now you know how a uptrend looks like, how a downtrend looks like, and how a range bound looks like. And this is a perfect example of a range bound. CESC, it's a power company. They're in power generation, power distribution. And this stock for almost a year, it was in a range bound. So I hope now you understand the concept of trend, concept of, you know, uptrend, downtrend, range bound. So again, type bull if you have understood what a trend is, what a uptrend is, downtrend is, range bound. Any bear, no bear. Good. We are good. We are bull, so we are good. Next is, what is support and resistance? So support and resistance are the points at which the whole demand supply equation changes. Like, let us say we are going again to purchase onions. And, you know, India is anyway a price sensitive nation. Many of us are privileged, but there are people, you know, who don't earn much. And for them, a 10 rupee per kg increase is a big increase. So when the prices go very low, they will make onion paratha. And when the prices go very high, they will see what is cheap. They will make that kind of paratha and they will eat. So now let us say onion is trading at 50 rupees. Not many people will buy it. But when onion comes down at 20 rupee, all of you will suddenly you'll see lot of people who are maybe poor, who are not able to afford onion parathas. Now they're interested in eating onion parathas and they're buying. All of a sudden you will see as the price came in their buy range, lot of demand for onion came, which was missing at, let's say, 50 rupees and all. So support and resistance are those price points where this whole demand supply game changes. And if you see some of these examples, see, this is a price of a chart of Ajanta Pharma. Ajanta Pharma price is falling here and around 900 to 950. This is the price range where it gets support, means you have more buyers and that is why it is not falling further. And this is the volume data. And you can see when it is falling, this was the volume, but all of a sudden big volume buying came and the price went up, which means the buyers and the bulls are dominating the bears. And then the demand is more than supply and it goes up. Again, it comes down, it goes up. But whenever it comes in this range, somehow buyers emerge because a lot of people are finding value at this price and they're willing to, you know, take the risk and buy. So this zone becomes a support zone and these two price points, they become a support price points where the bulls dominate the bear. And take this price point. Look, this is 2018 and this is 2020. And this is here where resistance came, where, you know, the sellers dominated, the buyers and the bears dominated, and the stock couldn't cross this price, it went up. Even after 2 years, when the price is trying to cross it, see the kind of effort it is trying to make, because this is a point where, you know, the bears, they start dominating and maybe people feel it is overvalued stock, they start selling it at this point, whatever happens, but this is the price point at which the stock faces a lot of resistance. So support is the price where your risk reward is in favor, because if you buy at this price and if even if it falls from here, you will lose 1 or 2%, but you will make 5 or 10%. But if you buy at this price, the chances are if it goes down, you are going to lose big money and you don't know how much of money you are going to make if it is going up. So support and resistance are the price point at which you take your buy or accumulate or your sell decisions. And this is how they work in terms of demand supply game. This is another chart. This is Happiest Mind. And again, as I said, we can pick any periodicity. So if you see Ajanta Pharma, it was a daily level chart. Happiest Mind Technology, it's a 4 hour chart. And even on 4 hour chart, you can see the same concept of support is working. So it depends which kind of chart you want to use, but the concepts remain same. So I hope now you understand the concept of support and resistance. And I have only taken the static support. We will talk about there is something called dynamic support. And when I say static support, this is a static price point. It doesn't change. So this is what I mean by static support and resistance. So type bull, if you now know the static support and resistance concept, any bears? Okay, we are good. Now let's look a little bit about price. So if you see, price itself highlights a lot of things. Like, see, this is a Marico chart and see how many times Marico tried to cross this level of 390 and every times it failed, which tells at this price, the bears are dominating the bulls. Also, if you see the wick also, it says something. It says lot of effort was made to go here, but it couldn't cross. And from this, see the fall which happens. It closes so low. So a lot of thing about this whole wick and the body also tells a lot of things about the price behavior. And see, finally, after 2-3 years, when it has crossed this price, now the same resistance is now acting as a support. The price came here, see, it shooted up, which means the bears, they just lost the power and the bulls took over and they took the price here. Again, same thing happened. Again, same thing happened. So price itself tells a lot about, you know, the overall bull and bear demand and supply equation. Why is volume important? Now, just imagine if there are five bulls who are going to provide support at a given price versus there are 50 bulls who are going to give support at a given price. So which is the more convincing, convincing point, when you have five people coming to buy or when you have 50 people coming to buy? Can you type? 50. Yeah, because there are more people, which means they're going to buy more, they're going to put more money, and there is more demand, it will go up. So volume is nothing but volume is the indicator of the, you know, weightage of evidence. So price can be manipulated. Like, it's very interesting how this whole 2008 fall happened and how this 2020 March fall happened. If you look through the charts, the volumes were missing. So it's like everybody is shit scared. Everybody's scared. They don't want to buy. Everybody's like, let COVID go, then I'm going to buy. So, you know, the buyers are gone from the market. The people who are already holding those shares, some of them are getting scared because they have not done their research. They don't have conviction. Some of them were doing leverage trades by taking loan, and now they have to clear the loan. So they are in loss. So because of the fear, they are selling. I don't know if you know the concept of pledge in finance. Companies, promoters, and many people, they do pledging of share, they take loan. So when the prices fall, the lenders, they sell that share open in the market. So, you know, some selling is happening because of all these reasons, and there are no buyers. So when there are no buyers and some selling is happening, you will get lower and lower price and lower circuits because there is no demand. So even if out of 100, two shares are getting traded, the prices will fall. And that is what happens in recession. It's not like fundamentals of company starts changing at that day itself. It's just the same demand and supply game. Sometimes on 10 shares, you get a lower circuit, and sometimes on 100 shares, you don't get a lower circuit because there are 100 buyers also fighting. So that is where the whole volume becomes very important, to analyze the volume. And volume is something which should be seen with respect to the price. If the price is increasing along with high volumes, that is something which is good, because price is not just increasing for namesake, and it's not like one or two operator who are driving the market. The volume says that there are a lot of people who are participating. So it's a genuine move. So, you know, the price direction and the volume direction together, they give more convincing power about the chart. So if you think in terms of probability, if price is giving you 0.2% probability, 20% probability, if volume is also telling the same story, your probability increases 40%. And then you look at more metric. And when you go through, get a high probability like 60, 70, 80%, then you do that trade because your chances of losing is high. And when you take 10 such trades on a probabilistic basis, you make money in 7 and you lose money in 3, and still at a portfolio level, at an overall trade level, you make money. So this is where volume is important. I will not get into nitty gritties, but I just wanted to highlight the importance of volume. So I hope you have understood the basics of volume, why volume is also important. Type bull if you have understood the basic importance of volume. Cool. Now let's go into moving averages. So I know all of you will understand the basic of moving averages. It is nothing but it is just the average. So if we are finding the moving average of last 10 days, we just do the basic average of last 10 day price, and that is what is the moving average price. So here we are doing 200 day moving average. So we are taking the closing price of last 200 days, and then this is the moving average of last 200 days. And on this day, I slide it by one row and I remove the 200th one day price, and I take this new price, and then this becomes my new 200 day moving average. And as I progress one day, I keep shifting this moving average, and this moving average keeps shifting. So this is a simple moving average. Exponential moving average is nothing but where, you know, you apply little bit of, you give some kind of weightage. So the recent prices, you give more weightage, the old dates, you give less weightage, and it's more of a weighted concept rather than just doing a simple average. So these are two types of moving average. Now how moving average works is, so I have taken three kinds of moving average: 20 day moving average, 50 day, 200 day. If you think in terms of mindset of a trader, this 20 days like a short term trading mindset, 50 is like a medium trend trading mindset, 200 is a long term trading mindset. So stocks which are in high momentum, these are the moving averages at which stocks get support. If you see this company called Zydus Wellness, see it has fallen here. It went up twice, and see the resistance, same price it got resistance, and when it has fallen, The same 200 day moving average, it is again getting support, again getting support. So this is called a dynamic support or dynamic resistance. So moving average is one indicator which acts as a dynamic support or dynamic resistance level. So here this 200 day moving average is acting as a dynamic support here in this talk. So this is the concept of moving average and why it is useful, because it acts as a support and resistance tool. See this talk. This stock is ICICI Securities, and again in 2019, this was one of the stock which gave good return, and this stock gave excellent return. Within a year, it doubled. And if you see, it was in high momentum and perfect uptrend. If you can see the higher highs, higher, and we'll do all of this in TradingView. Right now, I'm just explaining you the concept. Very soon, we are going to jump to TradingView and do all of this. So if you can see, these are higher highs, higher lows, and you can see the 20 day moving average line, how beautifully it has acted as support. One day, two, twice, thrice, and it needs to be somewhere around this, exactly not at this point. Three times, four times, five times, six times, seven times, eight times, and then it got broken here. So in short term, the 20 day moving average acted as support. In long term, the 200 day moving average acted as support. So I hope now you understand the contribution of moving average as an indicator in the trading strategy. Again, type bull if you have understood it. Okay, cool. Now let's go to this TradingView tool. And again, you know, it's a software in itself. In the given time, we cannot cover everything, but just to give you what TradingView can do, we will not cover all the functionalities, but I will cover what is important from what we are discussing from a technical analyst perspective. So, you know, you can do a lot of charting things. You can do collaboration. So it's like a Facebook of technical analysis. You can collaborate, share your charts, see what others are doing. You can plot a lot of indicators. You can do a lot of drawing tools. You can write your insights. You can track the market. You can have your watch list. You can have your screens where you can track companies which are showing some specific behavior. You can create alerts where, you know, if you want to buy above a certain price, you can get a SMS, you can get a mail, you can get a, you know, a message. So there are a lot of functionalities TradingView provides. And I have tried to capture all those functionalities here. We'll not cover everything, but we'll just see how to do a basic charting and how to see, use some of the support and resistance lines, how to draw trend lines, how to draw moving average lines, how to use moving average as support and resistance. And just using this simple concept, we will see some use cases, how we could have played and we can, you know, make money. Okay, I will do the Fibonacci also. I don't know if you will have enough time, but let me see. I will just show you if you all know what is a Fibonacci number, because I don't want to get into the mathematics of Fibonacci. That is going to take a lot of time. And what I will suggest is you also start doing these things along with me so that, you know, you also do some hands-on practice. So go to In TradingView, log in, and once you log in, you will see you have something called charts. So let me just open In.TradingView. When you open TradingView, when you log in, so this is how I have logged in. I have a paid version because I use it extensively for the functionalities. But even most of the things I will teach, you will be able to do in the free version. You have something called chart. You can click this chart, and once you click the chart, whichever is the default chart, it will open. So for me, Shopper Stop is the default chart. It is open. So, you know, it has so many functionalities. We'll go through the basics. So the first thing is how do we plot charts in TradingView? So this is the place where you can select your stock. And if you see, this is the place you select your index. So right now, this covers the whole world. The beauty is this tool, you can not only trade in India and do TA of India, you can do for overall world. And let me show. When you click this, you have all the stock exchanges of the world, and not only the equity, it covers commodity, cryptocurrency, everything. Now, if you want to keep your universe as the world, you can use all. But let us say we want to restrict ourselves to India. So I will type NSE, because in India, NSE, BSE, they are the two popular stock market exchanges. And by NSE looks like Nigeria. So this is the India map. This is the India exchange. So when I click this, then it means I am restricting my search to only Indian NSE stock exchange. And earlier in the world, if I select all exchanges and then if I search for Shopper Stop, see, you will see so many companies, Shopper 360 and all. And they belong to different Singapore stock exchange, I think this is. But if I restrict it to NSE, Then if I search, I will see only Shopper Stop, which is there on Indian Stock Exchange. And then if you click it, then you will get the chart of Shopper Stop. Let's say I want the chart of Infosys. So I go here and I type Infosys. And now you can see this is the Infosys chart. So are you doing this along with me? If you are doing it, can you type bull? Can you go and can you pick in TradingView Infosys chart? Don't worry about whether it's daily chart, weekly chart. We'll go through all of this. Cool. Okay. So now let us see some of these functionalities. So I'm skipping this. You can go through the TradingView portal. You can see what is the pricing, help center and all. Let's start with the basics, how to draw a chart. So first thing is what kind of chart, and we saw it's a, you know, candlestick chart we are interested in. So this is the place you can draw a bar chart. This is how a bar chart looks. See, and I am just zooming it. If you have a PC, because I use PC because for charting, I feel laptops are like, you know, for traders, laptop is like little smaller one. I use a desktop with a mouse and proper setup. So, you know, you can use your touchpad and mouse. You can just zoom by, you know, scrolling your mouse down. So you see, it's different from that candlestick. This is a bar chart. This is a line chart. It just says the closing price and all. So we are interested in candlesticks. So this is the candle we pick. So this is how a candlestick gets plotted. So now at least we have candlestick chart. So we know how to draw a chart at least. And you can just press control and then take your mouse and you can keep scrolling your mouse in forward or backward direction, and the timelines will keep changing. Or you can just press the mouse button and you can drag it. See, when I'm dragging, this hand is dragging. So this is how you can move your chart in terms of timelines. So now you know how to select a company, how to select exchange, how to draw a chart, how to select a chart type. Next comes what time period, and time period is based on what kind of trader you are. So let us say I am a positional trader. A positional trader means I will hold this stock for, let's say, 2 months, 3 months to maybe 1 year. So I might be interested in daily level chart. So this arrow, if you see, you can pick your chart at each of this level. You can even draw a chart at a 1 minute level, which means 5 minute level. If I draw this at a 5 minute level, and why it has become like this is because, you know, this is a 5 minute level chart. If you see now, the time has changed. Every 5 minute is a bar. And let me just show you here. Every bar candlestick here is a 5 minute representation of open price, close price. So you can pick any time, and there are people who do this minute by minute kind of trading also. So I'm interested in 1 day, so I'll pick 1 day. And if you click this, then, you know, it becomes your favorite. So if I unclick, I will not see it here, but I want it here. So I clicked it and you see day came. So I don't need to go here. Or even if you want to define your own timelines, you can go here and you can do, let's say I want a 15 day chart. I don't see it. So let's remove this 15 day here. I don't see 15 day chart here as option. So I can create days. I can create 15. I can create add and 15 day come. And then I can have a 15 day chart here. So let me just minimize it. And this is from 9. Let me change the time. So now each and every candlestick is 1 15 day view. So this is 1st January and this is, you know, 22nd January. This is basically 15 trading days. So I'll go back to daily. So this is how you pick your time periods. So I hope all of you now know how to change the time period in the chart. Type bull if you know how to change the time period in the chart. Okay. So we have seen how to change the time period. There is something which is very important called scaling, and let me show why this is important. And let me just go back to the world chart because that's the best example to show it. How many of you heard about the 1929 crash? Have you heard about the 1929 crash? Can somebody type what happened in 1929? Just type if you know about 1929 crash, what happened. And see, Indian market is still, you know, from 1970s, 80s, and the data is from 1990. US market, it's there from 1920, 1900. It's 100 plus year old market. In fact, see, the chart data is available from 1897. And can somebody tell me what happened in 1929 crash? Great Depression. Good. So Great Depression, which happened, and the markets went for a toss. But see, this is what 1929 is. Do you see anything here? Do you see any movement here? Doesn't look like big fall happened, right? Let me just change it to log mode. This is the same chart, but see now from 361, it has fallen to 39. This is almost a 90% fall. But when you saw in auto mode, visually you couldn't identify it. Actually, it has happened. It's just that you couldn't identify it because here it works on an absolute scale. And because now the market is at 33,000 level, this number was too less. But when you go on a log scale, it works on a percentage scale, and every percentage fall is equivalent. So it's very, very important to understand how you plot your charts and what kind of scales you are using, because all the concept of support, resistance, trend line plotting can go for a toss. Because most of the people deal with 3 month, 4 month chart, you don't see the difference between your log and auto scale. But when you are dealing with multi-decade charts, it is very, very important to take care of scale. And the long-time investors who use technical analysis to decide their buying and selling points from a long-term investment perspective, they are very cautious about their scale. So, you know, we have learned some of the basics. And now what I will do is, let's go back to our Shoppers Stop chart and daily chart here. Now let's try to use some of these indicators. So far you have only price and you have only volume. And let's say I want to bring my moving average indicator now. So you see this FX here, click this FX thing, and this arrow you will have. Right now you will not have anything because you don't have favorites. So click on this FX and see, you have multiple things. You have favorites, my script, built-in. Again, I will not cover everything, but go click this built-in. These are the built-in indicators. And let's say I am interested in exponential moving average. So type exponential moving average, or just type moving average. See, when you type moving average, you get moving average multiple types. Click on this moving average exponential. When you click it, you see apart from volume, you will see here there is something called EMA9 which has come, which means by default, it has plotted a 9-day moving average, and now you see a moving average line along with the price. Let's change it to 20. So again, there are various ways you can play with it. And I'm changing it to 20-day moving average. So you can go to inputs, and in the length, you can make it 20. So now I have a 20-day moving average line. I want 50-day and 200-day also. So again, I go, and if you want to again make it your favorite, you can just, you know, mark a star there. So I can mark a star and make it my favorite. And again, I'm plotting one more and one more. So I have now 3 moving average line. Again, default 9. This I change it to 50. And what color is this? Okay, let's see. And third one, I will make it 200. So that I can have a short term view. Also, I can have a medium and, you know, long term view on the same stock. And let's say I want to change the color, the 200 day moving average line, let's make it black. 50 day moving average line, let's make it green, because above this I will be in the stock, below this I may not be. And blue is my 200 day. So this is how you plot these moving average indicators. So now let's go back to some of our, you know, slides. Let's go through some examples. So you saw this moving average chart. This was Zydus Wellness, and we saw how the support is happening. Let's try to do in TradingView. So from Shoppers Stop, let's change to Zydus Wellness. And you can see it's Zydus Wellness. This is India. This is NSE. This is BSE. I'm picking Zydus Wellness, NSE. This is a daily level chart. This is my moving average line. This is my price line. Sorry, just 1 second. I will tell you later on why that came. Yeah. So see, this Zydus Wellness chart is from 2016 till 2021. This is a weekly chart, and this is 200 weeks moving average line. This is a super long term line. So I shift from daily to weekly, and this has gone haywire because my price ranges are not in line. So I'm just dragging it to, you can do it by dragging again the Y axis, or you again go back to log auto, and I'll go to log because this is a little long-term duration chart. And now I have my Zydus Wellness thing here. See, somehow in the past I have seen this chart and I created some of these indicators just to watch. And the beauty is TradingView, it's in cloud. It saves each of these chart, everything what we are doing. I brought that also, so I'll just remove it. Now you can see between 2016, what we had plotted, it got support, and you can see the stock getting support somewhere here and again around this line. So we have been able to plot this in TradingView. So we know now, let's say if you want to plot support and resistance, static one, and let us say this is a line, you see, this used to be a resistance because the price kept going up here and then it couldn't cross here. And see, after 3-4 years, when the stock fell from this same level here, the stock got support here and the stock got support here. So if you want to, you know, visually see a support resistance line, I can draw a horizontal line. So you go here and you can take this horizontal line and you can just click your mouse and now you have a line here. Again, you can play with this line and you can do a lot of stuff. You can change the color, you can change the type, you can make it dotted and whatnot. You can do all sorts of things. So now you see this, which was this point price, which was a resistance, it acted resistance here also and price fell. Again, it tried to go up and finally third time it crossed this resistance. And then the moment it crossed it, the same resistance became a support. Let me show. When it fell, now it's getting support at the same price point. And the reason why it happens is these are levels at which big guys, they change their hands. And let us say somebody who was invested for 5 years, he sold, and somebody big who is new, he took this share. He's not going to sell in 1 month. So whenever it comes here, if the big guy has purchased here because he found value, whenever price comes here, he will like to purchase again. And that is why it keeps getting support again and again. And unless if that big guy sells his shares here, then you will see a massive fall occurring because the big party has sold, and then you will see. So what is happening here, because the hands have been changed, now the same resistance is acting as support, again support, again support. So if you draw this line, you know where you will get your support, and there could be multiple support and multiple resistance lines here. So this is how we draw a support resistance line. And if you want to draw a trend line like I showed you, so let's see which chart we try to draw the trend line. Or let's see Ajanta Pharma chart. Or no, we don't have much time, so let's draw a trend line. So Mayur Unicoaters, this is a daily chart 2019. So go to Zydus Wellness, select Mayur Unicoaters, Mayur Uni, and you get this Mayur Unicoaters NSE selected. Now we are at a daily level chart and we are in 2019. So just either scroll at this side and you'll see 2019. And we have plotted this from 2019 January to 2019 August. So this is 2019 January. So I'm just increasing it to give you a better feel of the downward trend. And this is 2019 January. And there are multiple ways to draw a trend line. You can take this low and you can keep connecting these lows. And to make it better, I will just change the, you know, instead of dotted, I will go for the line. I will make it a little thin. And maybe I will make the color black. So this is the downward. So you can draw the trend line here. You can do a copy paste also. And I did a copy paste, control C, control V, and the higher highs. So you need to connect the lower highs and lower lows, and you have your trend lines here. The other way to draw it is, let's go to Shopper Stop chart. And I adjust it. I go here. And let's say this Shopper Stop right now, it's in uptrend. So I can draw a channel also. So you can see you have something called parallel channel. Go here, the second option, parallel channel, and take your cursor, press your mouse at this point. So this is my starting point of lower lows. I take my cursor up. Let us say I am trying to see this channel till here. Release the cursor here. After releasing the cursor, press the cursor again and you see a dot is getting created, and go up because you want to draw the channel. And you can take the high points, and you know, we can extend this channel because this was the lowest where it got created, and you know, we can extend this high. So the idea is still the if you see how beautifully this channel is working, see the higher highs at the end of channel and see the lower lows almost here. So the idea is, if the trend continues, you can just extend this channel, and you can expect when the stock will go up, you can decide where you want to sell. So you can create your resistance also, and you can decide your sell point. And this is a good risk reward because it's, again, it's crossing this channel, it's going up. If it is here in this channel, you can take a position here, you can sell here. So this is how you can do your risk reward analysis also using some of these indicators. And lot of such tools are there. There are 20, there are multiple strategies. Like there is a something called Elliott wave theory, which works on a different way. Like I showed you how the moving average theory works. There's a Elliott wave theory, there are Gantt chart, there are multiple things. Somebody asked me how to do a Fibonacci retracement. So let me show one chart where Fibonacci really works as beauty. And I'm not getting into, you know, mathematics of Fibonacci, but Fibonacci, they are like certain numbers are Fibonacci numbers. And the beauty is the ratios of those numbers are called golden ratio. And a lot of universe has been created around those Fibonacci numbers. Like the ratio in which the trees and the branches, you know, at what if you take the whole length of the tree, at what percentage of the length of the tree the branches happen, or in terms of body structure, a lot of the things work in those ratios. And looks like this thing works in stock market also. And let me show you the example how to do that. And after this, we'll, you know, jump through some of the strategies. So I am taking Greenply Industries, and this is Greenply Industries chart. And you can see clear downtrend, and then this was a range bound, and then there's an uptrend. So let's say I want to do a Fibonacci retracement for Greenply, and you can go here. Sorry. Yeah, go to the third one where you see this Trishul kind of thing, and you have something called Fib retracement. So let us say I take this lowest point and this highest point, and then I drag it. Now what you see is there are certain levels which have got created. These are the levels of correction, and these number ratios which you see, these are the golden Fibonacci ratios. Now the what market says, the Fibonacci analysis of the market says, these ratios act as support and resistance. And if you see, really it does. If you just think from a normal support and resistance perspective, you know, these were the points which acted as resistance here, and here it is acting as a support. Many times these ratios and the support and resistance, they overlap each other. And see how beautifully this 0.61% retracement is overlapping, 50% retracement is overlapping. The other way to do is, so this tells you if the stocks corrects from here, where it is going to get support. So one way is your moving averages. One way, in fact, look how beautifully the 50-day moving average has acted as a support here. One way is like this Fibonacci number. One way is your static price. What was your previous support? And when multiple of these things come together and act as a common support and resistance, that gives a stronger evidence of support and resistance. So nothing like a gospel of truth. Everything works on probability and things can go wrong. But more of these things come together, more better, you know, the whole weightage and our probability of success of telling whether, you know, it's working or not. So this is how Fibonacci retracement works. So there are a lot of tools, and you can do a lot of things here in this. You can take a brush and, you know, you can highlight something here, or, you know, you can take a rectangle. And, you know, when you learn full detailed trading, you will know why, when you use all of this. And you can do back testing, you can do coding. There are a lot of things. They have something called Pine Editor where, you know, like in Python, you code, you can do a lot of coding, you can build algorithms, you can test those algorithms. Again, I'm not getting into details of all of these. You can save the chart templates. You can create a chart template. Like if you like this 20, 50 day moving average, you can create this template. You can save this template here. You can do a lot of things. So I'm just giving you a bird's eye view of, you know, how to do it. I'm planning to put some of these videos on my YouTube channel because I have some of these courses where I have these learnings. I'll put some of these YouTube channels you can follow, and then there you can learn again TradingView in detail. But let's jump a bit, given now at least you know how to draw a price chart, how to play with time, how to draw moving averages, how to see the volumes. This is sufficient for us to go into our strategy. So let us look at some of the trading strategies now. So type bull if so far you are good and you are able to at least, you know, work on the TradingView software on your own. You are able to plot these charts. Can you type bull? If anybody has issue, type bear. Good, we are good. So let's jump further. So we have crossed TradingView. So see, before any trading strategy, let's understand the market psyche. So this is how the market psyche works. You know, there is an accumulation phase where the most intelligent guys enter and not everybody is convinced. Like this is a phase where, like, you know, this is like the April of post-COVID, May of post-COVID. Not everybody is convinced. But those who have seen multiple cycles of market in terms of trading, investing, they know these are the right price points to get the value. They enter and then prices start moving up. And this is where the euphoria start building and then lot more people start coming. And then like everybody, you know, gets excited. And then this is the time where, you know, we call something called Nausicaa, who has not seen a market cycle. He comes, and I clearly remember in 2008, I was working in TCS. So before my MBA, I worked for a few years. And in TCS, in my whole 2 years, I never saw people discussing about stock market. 2017, July, August, December was a time when everybody was talking about Reliance Power IPO in my company. And I have very clear memories. That is the place where, you know, the big bubbles happened. And then the intelligent guys who have entered here, usko kehte hai maal chipkana, chipkao fai karo aur nikal jao. They sell and they exit because they know things will go haywire because market is a cycle. After good news, bad news comes. After bad news, good news comes. And the mean to reversion works. Things don't go in the same direction. You know, raat hoti hai, savera hota hai. It's like after morning, night. That is how market works in cycles. So if you are a guy who doesn't want to work in, you know, trade in commodities, you don't want to do F&O, you just want to go in cash. You want to play on the long side. So this is the place where you have to, you know, play. Whether you trade or invest, if you are not ready to do shorting, you have to invest in this phase. And this is the phase you have to be cautious. So how to invest in this phase or how to invest in this phase? And nothing is good or bad. Somebody who is a momentum investor, he might like to wait and enter here because you never know. This will take 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, and you will not make a lot of money here, but you will make quick money here. But the fall is also quick. So a momentum investor knows when to enter, when to exit, make quick money, but he sits out many period of time. But a value investor who used trading, he would like to enter here at a low price and he would like to ride the whole journey. And he might feel the stock is highly overvalued here. He might like to sell here. But if he's a trader plus investor, he might understand the valuation. He might understand the momentum. He might ride the whole thing. So depending on everybody's skill, whether he's good at funda, he's good at technical, he's good at both, you know, you can ride. But the thing is to avoid this phase and this phase. So let us understand. So, you know, we understood price, we understood volume. So everybody's technical analysis or everybody's trading system is a mixture of some of these things. You need your price data, you need your volume data. This is like, you know, the, you know, holy grail. You cannot do anything without it. But above this, we try to look for some supporting metric for the trend. So how do we know the trend? So moving average is one way of identifying the trend. So moving average doesn't only help you on the support resistance, also the trend. And why the simple example is, let me show again. So one simple example of moving average, where did it go? Yeah. So you can keep riding the trend. Let's say you will enter in the stock when the stock is above its 20-day moving, when the closing price is above 20-day moving average, when the 20-day is above its 50-day moving average, when the 50-day is above its 200-day moving average. Let's say this is a strategy. And you know, the prices will go up, your average will also go up. So it's a trend-based strategy. And the moment your price goes below 20-day moving average or 50, you have decided you will sell. So, you know, you can ride this journey from here to here and which one to, you know, choose has its own pros and cons. but you are a pure trend-based investor following moving average strategy. You can ride from this to this if you build your rules around it. So this is what I meant, how to use moving average for trend. And let me go a little back. And there's something called momentum, which is the rate of change of trend. So it is like, you know, when you run, you know, you will start very slow and then, you know, you'll peak up. Like if you jog on a treadmill, you start at 4 kilometers, then you pick up at 8, 10, 12. Then, you know, you have reached your limit and you will start slowing. That slowing down is an indicator that, you know, your energy is getting exhausted, but still you have not slowed down your moment. So moving average is a lag indicator. By the time moving average plays its role, again, if you go back to moving average, you know, by the time you come here below its 50-day moving average went low, you have lost this much of amount from 520 to 420. So can you use some leading indicator? And that is where the concept of momentum and rate of change and velocity comes. And again, there are a lot of statistical analysis which is done, but the idea is to look for rate of change. And if there is a slowness in that moving average itself, you get out. So that is where momentum and other indicators come. So usually any kind of trading system is a mixture of, you know, these three, four. And for trend, you will have 30, 50 different indicators. For momentum, you will have multiple indicators. The idea is not to work on 100 indicators because simplicity works. The idea is to pick a proxy for trend, pick a proxy for momentum. Like here, I have picked moving averages. For momentum, I pick something called a RSI, and I'm not discussing it here, but you know, it's another concept. So the idea is to build these three, four indicators and then build a system around it. Now I have two strategies. One I call a reversal strategy, which I follow more as a value investor. And as a value investor, it's like, you know, the prices are falling and nobody likes to catch a falling knife. But how do we know that it has fallen enough and the value has emerged? So if you see this area, the price kept falling. And this is the first time, you know, it fell. It went up. It has fallen again. But now the lows have not crossed this previous low. In fact, the lows are higher. And then it goes into a rectangular narrow band and it trades up and down and up and down. The other interesting thing which is happening here is, if you see till here, the volume was missing, but slowly the volume is coming back. This is one big green line, which means some big buying happened here. And even if there's a red line, the prices are not falling much. But here, despite of low volume, the prices were falling. So when despite of a high volume, the price, the percentage of fall becomes slow, the lows are not getting crossed further, the stock is moving in range bound, the green candles are followed by high volume green candles, and slowly the volume is increasing. These are signs that big guys, big mutual funds, big investors, they are finding value. And why value? Because so much of fall has happened. So when prices fall, your PE or whatever metric you take, price to sales ratio, your all financial metric, the more the price falls, given your earnings is constant, the more attractive becomes. But it doesn't mean that the market will be pessimistic or optimistic, because these are sentiments. So how do you match your financial valuation with the technical sentiment? This is how you do it. And then when you see the volume picking up and slowly you will see the moving average, slowly the stock starts going above its 20-day moving average, 50-day moving average. And then, you know, the stock starts creating optimism and then the price goes up. And then from 70 rupees, the stock goes to 170 rupees and see the kind of volume which has come. So this is what I call reversal strategy, where I don't take my positions in one go. I know it will continue for 3 months, 6 months, 12 months. I try to keep looking at these indicators, these volumes, and there are many more things. I don't want to go into detail. So one thing is RSI. If you see the RSI, it is a rate of change of momentum. And you can see slowly it from, you know, 20, it has gone up and then it is maintaining this value around 40. And then it is going up further. And then even if the fall is happening, it is around this 40 and then it goes above 50. So when all of these things, they talk with each other, I keep increasing my position. So let's say if I have to, I have a 100 rupee portfolio and let's say I can allocate 10% to this stock. Maybe here I will take a 1 rupee position. Here I will take a 3 rupee position. I have taken 5% position. I'm still waiting for money to be made. I will put 2 rupee more. I'll pay 2 rupee more. And then over a period of 5-6 months, I deploy it, because nobody can time it to perfection until, you know, you are an insider or your information. And then you ride this journey and then you use other techniques. Again, see where the resistance has come. The resistance has come at the previous big resistance level, the same price, and here same price. So maybe this is time where the stock is going to consolidate and maybe I can book some profit. So this is a basically a reversal strategy, and this is how we should look at the price and, you know, all these things. And this is more like a, you can say, trend strategy, or a golden cross is when your closing price is more than 20 day moving average, your 20 days more than 50 day, 50 days more than 200 day. The idea is to get into a stock and you will see huge volumes coming here, and you take a position and you ride the position till, you know, if you are a very, you know, conservative like guy, momentum guy, you don't want to go below 20 day moving average. But if you are like a 1 year kind of mindset investor, you can keep it at 50 day moving average. So if you are, your stop loss was 20 day, stop loss means your exit point. So you could have exited here, but if you have it 50 day, maybe you would have lost 50-100 rupee. But still you are making money even if you enter here, 30, 40, from 40 to 160, you are making money and then you are exiting. So this is a trend-based strategy. So you know, if you are entering at a value and that value comes into a trend, imagine the kind of money which can be made. So type bull if you have understood these two things, how to ride a trend and, you know, how to identify when the, you know, reversal is happening. Type bull if you have understood these two concepts. Good. Good. So now let's go through some real use cases. So we'll discuss five use cases using this. And these are use cases where, you know, I have done these trades in last few years. So anybody being, you know, MBA finance guys, I know you'd be reading, you know, Economic Times and all the newspapers. Have you ever seen photo of this person, or if you do stock analysis? I will tell you, this stock has been one of the most talked stock in, you know, stock market world in last 1 year. It has given more than 5 times return. So it's a part of those 66 stocks. He's the promoter. Do you know who is he? I'll give 5 seconds. If anybody knows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you are tech savvy, you can do some image search. I'll give you one more hint. Gets this logo. This is the logo of the company, which, you know, he is, you know, driving. One, I'll give 5 seconds again. 1, 2, 3, 4. I know we all hear about Sun Pharmas and, you know, Infosys, TCS. These are mid and small cap companies. Somehow I play in these companies because, you know, the chances to make money is bigger. So remember this, the big money is lost. And now we are getting into, you know, your finance stuff, the whole financial world. And we will see how we will connect the financials and the technicals. So the big money is lost when the earnings fall, when the margins fall, when the derating happens. So imagine, I don't know how many of you have traded, you know, tracked. Great, he is Satyanand Chava. Great, he is Satyanand Chava. He is promoter of Laurus Labs. So if you have tracked the pharma industry between 2010 to 15, it gave excellent returns. And the leader of pharma, Sun Pharma and Lupin, they have given a negative return. In fact, right now also they are almost 50% down after 6 years. And they had their peak of margin. Everything was going in favor. The valuations were like, people were willing to pay 30, 40x multiples. But after that, it went into a cycle of regulation where, you know, they had a lot of regulatory hurdles, a lot of extra cost came in managing regulation, the margins fell, the business didn't do well. So from the, you know, if the business is doing from 40% margin, if the business comes down to 20% margin, even at the same revenue, you'll make half profit. So, you know, even if the valuation remains same, your price will decrease by 50%. And in bull market, people give 40 multiples because the prices have fallen. Everybody has lost hope because the valuation you pay is for next future 10, 20 years of earning. So let's say the valuation from 40 comes down to 20. So your, you know, your losses are more than 50% because the stock corrects by 70%. So this is what I mean. Big money is lost when the earnings fall, margins fall, derating happens. All the brokerage reports, they derate the stock. Pessimism takes over. We get scared. Chalo, 40% to paisa mil raha hai. Book the losses, exit. And then high volume sale happens. Take the reverse. Big money is, I'm sorry, this is big money is made. It's not lost. Big money is made. So big money is made when, I'm sorry, I forgot to reverse it, but big money is made when earnings rise, margins rise, re-rating happens, optimism takes over, and high volume buy happens. And you have seen in some of the examples what I mean by high volume by like the green pie chart. Now take the, this is the quarterly data of Laurus Labs. See what has happened between March 2018 to December 2019. And again, if you want to understand in detail, I have blogged about this company. You can go to my blog and you can see why this thing happened. See the company's net profit. It remained in the same range. And see the margins. The company has worked, you can see the margins even at operating margin level. In fact, if you look at the PAT margin, it's much more pathetic because see the kind of depreciation which was built. So it was not performing and something has happened. Last quarter, this company made, just imagine 45 crore profit to 273 crore profit. Even if you take seasonality, December to December, 18 crore profit to 273 crore profit. What changed in this? And this is not something which happened, you know, in a day. They were doing something which took time to reflect in the results. And when it reflected, you know, it just, you know, it just went into a different trajectory. And see, the margins went from almost from 18% margin to 33% margin. So this was an operating leverage story. In pharma, the kind of spending you do, it pays you after 2-3 years. And that is what has happened. Basically, they converted from an API company to a formulation company. And again, you need to understand the pharma industry and the value chain. What is the API and what is the formulation? But you know, there is an investor called Varinder Bansal. He used to be a CNBC analyst and he explained it beautifully. He called it churan. Like, oh, when something happens in North India, they say ki churan khalo, theek ho jayega. So API is the constituent which goes into that, you know, medicine making. And the tablet which you eat is a formulation. So of course, formulation is higher in the value chain and it's a higher margin business compared to API. And these guys, they were the API, they used to produce APIs for HIV drugs. And from API, they became a formulation player by their experience and hence the whole margin shift. But when you shift from your API to formulation, you need to go through 2-3 years of R&D spending. You need to create a team and you need to do a lot of things. So a lot of your money goes, but that money doesn't pay in terms of revenue and your margin falls. And by nature, you know, humans are greedy. We want results the next day. You know, in good times, everybody takes stake, but when things don't work, people sell stock and they see margin falling, pessimism takes over, and you get the same stuff at a very cheap rate. And then when the everybody starts doubting the management also, ki management bhaag to nahi raha paisa leke, and a lot of things happened. But when the story plays out, you know, this is the kind of return it makes. And this is how the price went. If you see from March 18 till May 2020, Laurus Labs price didn't move. And then again, the stock has gone through a stock adjustment. That time it used to trade at 300. It went into some 1200, split happened. So this is post split. So it became a five bagger, almost a 4-5 bagger from 70 rupees. And I have blogged about this because I track the annual reports. I make my notes. I place it on my, you know, blog. So in June, I had this notes and I could see what is happening. Now, let us see what has happened in stock technically. So before this, now let's jump to Trading View and let's take Laurus Labs chart. And all of you, please go and type Laurus Labs. Yeah, they splitted the share, rightly said. Good. Good to know you all track the markets. And let us see 1 year chart. Okay. And let us go a little deeper into Laurus Labs. So see this period, if you see what has happened. Now remember our reversal strategy. This is the point where, you know, nothing is happening. And you know, the stock was falling from 105 rupees. The stock came down till 64 rupees. Now see what is happening. The volume is missing. We call it triple bottom in technical terms. Three times it creates the same bottom. But see what is happening. And let's add the moving averages line also. So moving average, exponential, exponential, exponential. I'll plot the 20, 50, 100. This is 20. This is 50. This is 200. We are at daily level chart. We have volume. I'll plot RSI. RSI just think as a momentum indicator because I use RSI also. Now, if you see this chart, see nothing has been happening here. Okay. But slowly the lows, it stopped making further lows. And one time, two time, three time, four time, five time, It created the same low, and then the lows are becoming higher. And then your RSI, which was trading in the negative range, slowly RSI lower bound has become little high. Now it's not breaking the 40. And even the price, the volume is starting to build. If you see the volume is starting to build, and this line looks low because this is a huge volume line, and we'll discuss this. If you remove this big volume line, you can see some volume being built on the high days, and the price goes up, and now it has crossed, you know, the golden crossover. All that has happened. What happened here? One big party offloaded almost 5% stake. And see, we think if very big parties, you know, take big position, it's always works, but it doesn't always work. These guys were there in Laurus Labs for 5 years, and they just exited at the wrong time by just getting frustrated because nothing was happening. And you know, the results started coming in April, May, and that is the time they exited. And you know what has been the result after that. In fact, these guys, you know, they came and they gave one interview, and somebody asked what has been your lessons. And they said that their lessons have been more on the sell side. I think they were mentioning about Laurus exit. And see, this is where the golden crossover gets created. Close price is more than 20, 20 more than 50, 50 more than 200. Your reversal has happened. Your downside is protected. Even if it falls, you know, if you have taken a position here, even if the story didn't work, you could have exited at this stop loss on, you know, you would have lost 5-6%. And then now see your RSI. Your RSI always stays above this range. It never fell below this range. See the kind of volume buildup which has happened in this stock here. And then the stock became a 5-bagger. So now let us look at this company and again try to guess this personality. And I know you'll not know again because this is much more smaller company than Laurus. But guess this logo. Have you seen this logo anywhere? Again, this is another more than 5-bagger. This is a 8-9-bagger. So I'll give again 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this company, again, same thing has happened. If you see, the operating margins worked between, you know, 6-13%. And then if you see the operating margins, they have gone from to 19%. And the stock revenue also, it was in this range. You can see there is a shift in revenue growth, and the profit, which used to be in 1 crore to 9 crore, that profit has gone around 27 crores. And same story, the stock price has gone from some 250 rupees to 2200 rupees. It's almost a 10-bagger if somebody could invest at that low. And again, I have my notes here again around the same time when, you know, I could see the results changing, and I was aware of why this is not working. And I was waiting for the triggers for that thing to change, and I could see those triggers, you know, playing out in the result. And then you look at technical data. So this is how you blend the fundamental data. You track a story, you know, it is not working, but you believe in the management. They look honest guy. They are doing something good. You keep it on your watch list. You start keep taking small positions. You see some big changes happening fundamentally. Sometimes the results will first happen and then the price will show. Sometimes the price will itself show because the insiders, they will know, the suppliers, they will know, the customers, they will know, they will take position. And then results will come. So you need to look at both the things, and you will need to look for triggers. Sometimes the movement will happen and then results will come. And when both of them, they fall into line, then the technicals and fundamentals, they marry each other, and then the beauty happens. So again, let's go to this and let's plot Laurus Newland Labs chart. So this is Newland Laboratories. And if you see Newland Laboratories history, the price has fallen from 800 rupees to 200 rupees. And, you know, see the kind of volumes which got built here. Humongous volumes. Never ever happened. Maybe this is higher. And then the same golden cross happened. And before that, if you see, it was in this range for some time. And before this, for almost 2-3 years, the stock was below its moving average. In fact, I take the daily 200-day moving average line. I don't trade into stocks which are below 200-day moving average line. And see how beautifully it acted as a resistance here. Resistance, resistance, resistance. And this is where the golden cross happened. And same June, July time when the results turned. And then you just ride it. Even if you have a rule that you will not exit below 50-day moving average, you could have entered around 460 and you could have stayed till 1075. And still the earnings are good. So again, when it crossed up, again you enter, and again from 1100, you are riding this journey to 2100. So maybe you exited in between. So this is how people build their system and strategies, and they exit and they enter. So this is another example supported by volume, supported by price, golden crossover strategy and all. And again, the RSI has, you know, it doesn't fall further. And if you have a long-term investor, like 2-year view, which we are seeing here, better to look at weekly charts. These will look more beautiful on the weekly chart. So we went through the second one. Now use case 3 and 4 is just about riding the trend. Yeah, this was Newland. Yeah, he's Mohan Rao, Newland Lab, and he has two sons. I think Duatari Rao and one more. These two sons, they run the business. And if we look at Mohan Rao history, for one of the global MNC pharma companies, he was the R&D head. And you know why this company has performed? Sun, Lupin, a lot of these companies had a lot of regulatory issues because most of these people, they sell to US, and US have somebody called USFDA, who is the regulator. It is one of the most stringent regulator. They come visit the plant, and if you know, they don't find plants in, you know, proper condition, they don't allow you to sell the medicines. So Newland has a very, very good track record. They never got, you know, USFDA observations in the last 15 years. And it used to be a commodity company. Again, if you look what is changing in Newland, you need to again see from commodity kind of, you know, API work, they are doing some niche work and they're doing well into CRAM. So again, you need to go to the fundamental, understand the revenue mix change and the margin shift. Also, there was a raw material price cyclicity. So a lot of things played in favor. So, you know, there are multiple levers. When they work towards you, you get this kind of price movement. And when they work against you, you get butchered. So it's all about tracking fundamental, tracking technical, and doing this. This is like riding pure trend. So this is the ICICI Securities. And this was a time when the mid-cap, small-cap space was not doing well. And if I can plot these charts for you, ICICI Securities. So this is the brokerage arm. Some of us have accounts here again, because I have used these charts extensively. You can see this. So all you needed to do, you need to just ride this momentum, and let me just remove all of this. And you can, by this time, I think you can plot all these things on your own. But the idea was, once fundamentally, you know, the stock is in trend, the golden cross is done, you could have entered here. And you could have just played till the 50-day moving average got broken, and you could have exited here. So this is how we do a trend-based investing, and you know, we ride the trend. One more chart I will show you for this, which is Abbott India. And if you see Abbott India, when the whole market was not performing, it was performing. And when the market is performing, it is not performing. And you know, many times as investors, we make false hopes. And we try to stay in a stock for 5 years despite of not making money. Whereas there is a time value of money also. If your money doesn't work for 5 years, you are losing at least the FD interest return which you would have got. And if you see Abbott charts, see what has happened. Abbott created a lot of wealth when the market was not performing. And even in COVID times, it just felt bit and it went. But see what has happened to Abbott now. It is in downtrend. It's clearly visible it's in downtrend. Lower highs, higher lows. So it's better to book profit and exit. I mean, that is where you can blend technicals. You know, we are finance guys. We use a lot of fundamental analysis, but that is where blending technical comes, and somewhere it starts reflecting in results also. If you check the Abbott results, you'll know what I'm talking. And just look at the Abbott valuation also, because despite a good result, again, go back to IT boom story, what happened to Infosys, same kind of things happen. So this is one example. Now I'd like to discuss something which is happening right now. So there is a company called Shopper Stop, and I know all of you will be knowing because you visit malls. So, you know, this whole COVID, a lot of things have performed, but there are stocks which have heavily impacted by COVID, which has not moved. Why? Because the malls are closed, or maybe because if you look at the chart of Inox Multiplex PVR, or if you look at education stocks like Navneet, you know, colleges are closed, schools are closed. So some of these stocks, they have not performed, but I see something very interesting which is happening in Shopper Stop. And if you remember the Green Ply reversal, if you remember the Laurus Lab reversal, just remember that concept and see what is happening in Shopper Stop. See, Shopper Stop made a low in May 20 at 127, and right now it is at 204. If you see how the other companies have done, like most of the companies have doubled, this is not even doubled, but see what is happening. When the fall is happening, it's with lower value, lower volume. But when the rise is happening with higher volume, which means strong parties, they're accumulating the stock, and they're, somebody's bringing down whatever, there's not demand. And whenever the price comes around this level, again, more volume comes. And the lows are slowly increasing. and the volumes are increasing. So somebody is accumulating these stocks in big, big, big volumes. And if you see the RSI, which used to trade low, this RSI has also gone high, high, high. And now slowly the RSI has found a support around 40. So looks to me the same story is repeating, and maybe next 3 to 4 months, 6 months, when everybody is vaccinated, may the malls can open with 100% timing and they will get back, life will get back to normal. Maybe that will be the time when, you know, the stock will fly. And if the stock flies, what is the kind of, you know, and why it stopped here 269? Look at this also. See this chart. In 2017, this thing acted as a support, and now the same thing acted as a resistance. So first it needs to cross this level. And right now, if you see, this is the level on a weekly chart. The stock has got multiple support, 194 to 200 rupee. And even in this fall in last 1 month, it got support at the same level. It looks like it is reversing. So maybe the risk reward ratio is good here, but it needs to go till here and it needs to cross here if it has to make the next high. So looks to me next 3 to 4 months, this is a COVID theme play where as the mobility improves, this stock is expected to do well, and it is still in reversal phase. It has not gotten into that golden crossover phase. If you see the daily chart, you know, it's close to there. It looks like it will do in next 2 to 3 months. So this is like something which is a very latest example, because, you know, hindsight, everything looks like, you know, it works like perfect. So I thought let's give example of something which, you know, which is something which is very relevant in current times. So, you know, we have gone through some of these examples. We know how to use these tools. So this is where, you know, I would like to end it here. Type bull again if you understood these 5 use cases and you're good. You don't have much questions on this. If you liked the video and want to watch more such videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also, we run a scientific investing training program where we teach about fundamental analysis, technical analysis, techno fund analysis, quants investing. If you want to know more about the program, please reach out to us on our email ID or do visit our blog, Facts Beyond Numbers, or you can also go at the LMS site, which is mentioned below.